Hey guys, welcome to Cop Factor. Today we're gonna be playing Dungeons & Dragons Dark Alliance, the newly released game on Xbox Game Pass. Joining me today is my co-op partner, Xander Knight.
Hey guys, Xander here.
We already started playing this game yesterday, but because of a technical problem, we didn't record any of the footage, just the voice. So today we're going to be showing day 2, mission 2, act 2 of the first mission actually, for this, and I'm being generously how I put it, game. Now, Dungeons & Dragons Dark Alliance is a third-person action RPG, molded after the Dungeons & Dragons IP, but not really. It's slightly different. This was developed by Tuke Games, a small Canadian gaming company. I don't know. It's a weird game. What do you think, brother?
It's unfinished, it's unpolished, and it needs a lot of work, but still might have some potential, but I think it's pretty much linear, and it's gonna get, let's say, boring really fast. A lot of currencies, collecting gold, crystals, and other things. So I think Anthem or Outriders is much better game than this.
It has a bit of feel of Warhammer Vermintide 2 in it, or even the first one. It's similar. You pick between these four presets of characters: the dwarf, the barbarian, the archer, the World of Warcraft rogue, and you level them up individually, clearing missions, earning loot, unlocking talents, spending some resources here and there. And the concept of the game is not bad, the execution is. I mean, it's a very unpolished, unfinished game, just like my brother said. We didn't enjoy it yesterday. Let's see if it's better now. We already got a bit of loot from the first level. And now we just have to see if this can get any better. Because so far it's... I don't know. It's one of the worst games out there.
Don't forget to mention the storyline is non-existent as well. So at least if you would have played the game, at least it would have had a good storyline. This, I don't even understand it or know it.
Yeah, so far we don't know anything. It's just, it's these four guys that are all kings and all related or somewhat, and they have to fight a dark alliance of enemies that
consist of goblins, orcs, trolls, and so forth.
And maybe undead too. Necromancers and stuff. I don't know. You just have to form the party here and select the mission and jump in the portal just like in Vermintide.
Exactly like in Vermintide. They're missing the dome. Fast.
Yeah, they don't have the energy dome here. They didn't bother with the energy dome. They said the platform is fine. And there's my brother, dashing with the speed of light.
Yeah, the characters are pretty much...
The only part that I actually like so far about the game is that you can jump.
I hope you've never regretted traveling, though I'm sure doing so.
But that's about it.
The jump is the only good thing about the game. So.
So far, yeah. Okay, so I'm choosing here the first mission act to halls of Duergar. From their halls. It was Duergar. And we pick hero difficulty because we meet the level, the power level requirement. And now we have to go here.
I'm coming, let's see.
This main hub where you start the game every time is really bare bones. You just have the merchant, a trophy case, a chest where you get all the loot. You cannot equip loot that you get during a mission. You can only take the loot from the main hub chest after you completed the mission. If not, you lose everything.
I don't know if you really lose everything or it always stays in the loot chest. No idea.
Haven't exited the entire game during a mission. We always entered and exited out of the main hub.
True. The maps are fairly linear and nothing quite new. You get checkpoints along the way that are like a pot with a fire underneath that you
Dwarven
can
defenses
either
are
rest
matched.
or
What a price they pay for their
you can get
Or
what
at least
exactly?
the
Loot
loot
rarity,
this
yeah.
destruction
Loot
saved
rarity of
many
the
who will
next
live to
the
rebuild it.
next coming
That's
area.
true. But there is a toll to seeing the halls this
There
way.
is a horrible
It will
slight
take time to recover.
latency to the destruction of objects in this game. Alright, in the spike, great. Thing again.
Gain Dwarven Rood Stone. The first one didn't really work, did it?
Whoa! That kills me. Oh, almost died.
Yeah, the jump mechanics is awesome, and the traps and everything else is. Yeah, not good.
Something
not
is missing.
Good.
We need a level for this.
Go ahead and find it. You have a jump here. I think we need another Dwarven cube.
Got it. What's over there? You found the elevator?
Some nasty dwarves that wanna kill us.
Really? What isn't that something? You can combo attacks, but you have to manage your stamina. The lock-on camera is horrible. It zooms in on the character and you can't see anything around you.
Found the lever and I went down with what the fuck, the lever's an elevator, dude.
Yeah, I thought you knew. Wait, I'm fighting up here.
I'm down, I'm gonna come up.
If you can. Oh, don't bother, these guys, they don't really want to fight me. If I just walk away from them, they leave me alone.
I'm coming back up. Jesus, the elevator is so fidgety and buggy. Cannot believe this. Oh, it's a troll, man, and he died?
Yeah, this is the first troll we encountered. You know what this has to do with Dungeons and Dragons? Nothing. It's just a dungeon crawler where you explore, find materials, and battle monsters, but the monsters are dumb, you have no choices. No, not one character is less stupid on taking on a specific enemy during any fight. You can play this game co-op or either solo with any one character, and everybody has a ranged attack, everybody has a melee attack.
Everybody has something, but the ranged attacks are bugged.
Yeah.
At least for
this
the melee classes, they if you're in front of me, if you're near somebody and you wanna shoot, they just bounce off them in another direction. It's just so buggy.
So good luck if somebody tries to shoot at an enemy while the other one's up close trying to melee the guy, then...
Take a look at the graphics while you go down with the elevator. Look at this. It's beautiful.
You're twitching a bit.
All four must be sealed back
and
up.
The walls look like... they're rendering in slow motion, and this I think is 60 FPS.
Yeah.
Because it has been optimized for the Xbox Series S and X. The enemies don't even notice you until you effectively hit them a couple of times. But if they could, they could just ignore you. All the time. You know, brother, I had a dream last night. I dreamt we played a really shitty game, and I guess that wasn't a dream after all.
Yeah, it wasn't. It's a really shitty game. What do dwarves have to do with this? What the hell?
Look at that, they're not even fighting us. Really, look, just walk around them. And you'll see they don't do nothing.
And
they're
killing each other.
No, he's getting up, but really slow.
Combo attacks are fairly easy to make. And there he goes.
Yeah, Awesome.
You have two buttons for the combo attacks, and
yeah,
there you go.
Guy was
here's
just
a combo.
His turn to get hit in the face. What is this?
Acid.
Oh, acid. The acid is gone.
Bada bim, bada boom.
If you just jump, the explosions and the ground effects won't hurt you. Oh, that was it? The breaching tunnel?
Okay, loot rarity.
You chose the loot rarity?
No, actually, if one of your teammates chooses loot rarity, then it applies to all of you.
Yeah, of course.
So another one cannot pick anything else, so it doesn't matter.
Apparently we have to do this 10 more times, or actually 9 more times. Oh, come on, you good luck.
No, some other guys blow up the small little ones, but whatever.
Down
there or this way with the guys that blow up.
Wait, there's a chest over here.
Oh, another troll.
Really? I locked on him, so I just give him a fighting chance.
I gained a lever handle and I got a rare chest. That's just great. I think I need to rest around here.
Yeah, me too, because I'm out of consumables.
Meaning
surprisingly
potion.
I was caught in a lot of explosions this round.
Okay, wait a minute. I have a lever here. I have the lever. It's here. There you go. And what does it do?
Oh, perfect. We needed this.
Explosive barrel. Oh.
Yeah, we have to.
Thank God for the explosive barrels. And down here, what's down here? Down here's something.
I'm thinking that's the way
up
we need to go.
There is something. You don't even have a map so you can guide yourself through this. You just go by instinct. Okay, this is the good way. This is the bad way.
This wouldn't be a problem, you know, as a dungeon crawler. This wouldn't be a problem because you can explore things, but in a fun game, sure.
Okay, let's see you go through the spikes. Ah, whoosh. And we're going.
You just have to wait and watch the pattern. This is laughably easy.
One stamina potion there, and what's here? Oh shit.
I don't know, a lever.
Gold.
Money. That's exactly where I put money. I think they took the concepts of Dungeons and Dragons in the most basic of sense. You know, you choose a character, you fight some monsters, and you get some more material. That's not what Dungeons and Dragons is all about. It's about cooperation. It's about luck.
Learning how to parry, dodge, when to hit, when to not hit.
Yeah, I want to roll a die.
I'll just let my tiger do the job for me.
Using your special ability. That's right, we have special
ultimate abilities. And they're so shit because they take so long to build up.
See, they drop bombs when they die. What an awesome mechanic. This is my ability. I get really pissed when I throw them in oblivion.
This is painful. Everything disintegrates when you hit an object. It disintegrates. It doesn't even, I don't know, do anything. Which okay, wait. Don't touch the lever. We have another way. Is this the way we came, or is it the other way?
No. This is the other way out of here.
Okay, here's a chest. Okay. Collectibles. A lot of collectibles hidden behind shit.
I like it when I throw the hammer that it actually doesn't throw the hammer.
Acid.
It just throws like a shockwave that does almost no damage.
Combo dead.
You know, I think you chose the more fun of the two characters because my guy is so slow. And I feel like I'm doing no damage to the dwarf.
I haven't even tested the special skill that I got of buying it or whatever. Okay, jump over the acid. Hope you don't die. Hit this crystal, just go fast. More trolls and more goblins. And I do this.
Well, okay. We have a lot of exploring to do because there are 10 of these things.
Okay, shit. Ow. Dangerous motherfuckers.
Oh. What the hell did he throw at me?
What the hell is this guy?
You died?
Almost died.
Oh my god. Here I come! Face the wrath! Don't face the wrath. Come on, get up.
They just pop in the wall and disappear. Jesus merciful Christ, this is just painful.
Oh great, another throw. A different color throw.
Isn't this like the bare minimum of the game? Okay, the acid.
I didn't even notice yet.
I'm still getting damage, although I'm not an acid in any way.
Oh, you know I can hit him from here. Ah, oh, he's spawning some acid spores.
I'm dead. That's just bloody. Give us a heal, why don't you?
Sure.
Thank you. Invincible. I am invincible. Wow.
I think we should have taken that elevator.
Take a rest.
Oh, surprisingly, we're not doing that well, but
we're not doing that horrible either way. Here is the place. Did you put the barrel inside that hole here? Did you blow it up?
It exploded, yeah.
Okay, and what's this place, this here? What's happening, right?
I'm going back because I fear we missed the lever portion.
No, I found a lever here.
Another one, I'm sure, but
gained lever handle.
Wow! Guess what? My stomp can destroy pools of this toxic goo. Look at that.
Oh, that's awesome. Now get it off me. It still does damage. This is unbelievable.
This is just
such a bug.
Him. I don't want to fight him. Hop on.
Oh,
good.
Objective complete. Okay. More trolls. More toxic little shitty trolls.
Oh, The animations look so stiff and unpolished. That's sort of a... It's just a beta.
I don't know if even a beta looks this shitty. I just throw him off the cliff into the molten lava, that's just funny.
You know, I keep dying, I don't know why. I mean, I don't actually die because I heal myself, but I get a lot of damage.
Short rest, another short rest available, this is awesome. I don't need a short rest, to increase the loot rarity.
I think I selected the short rest, but sure, increase loot rarity. This guy is Stone Grinder.
Time to beat the living shit out of this. Oh man, he pops you like motherfucker.
He's down. You can get some free shots. Walk away.
He blows himself up, really?
No, the battle. We just have to get them close to the barrels and use them to get some damage. Or I can just do this. Oh, that didn't do nothing. Oh, he's dead. How is he doing damage to me?
And I'm dead. Somebody revive me.
I'm dead.
Yeah.
I'm
dead. Thank you.
No, I died. Awesome. Just cut them around a bit before. Okay, never mind. Back to full power.
Back dead. Just get him a little further, he flinches away and just run back. So dumb. Dumb as nails.
Yeah, he's killing us though. I mean, you gotta respect that.
Man, his attacks are such shit.
Oh yeah, hit him now. Where did he go?
Okay, I'll hit him like this.
That's like a stun lock almost. Yeah!
Man, he hits like a motherfucker.
I hit that.
And that was it?
That was it. We didn't even find all the campsites, did we?
I don't think so. Ooh, okay. I got shit items.
No, what? And I was stuck in the tally screen for 10 seconds, like I could loot something or look around or do anything.
Yeah.
I don't know, I think we went everywhere. We must have missed something. Wow. My guy sucks, or better yet, I suck at this. Look at that. Barely killed anybody.
Oh, you killed a lot of people.
22.
My years training at the Melee Mac Fair continue to pay dividends.
Oh, another level. How gorgeous.
Yeah.
One attribute and one feat point.
That's gonna make the whole difference. Yeah! I got those legendaries. Those sweet, sweet legendaries that I don't actually know what to do with. Thank God.
You have better rolls on legendary, so that's good for
you. I can move a bit. No, I can. It teleports you back to the base.
As you can see, it's unfinished, linear, a bit annoying. Mechanics are clunky, graphics are clunky. So
we're not touching the feet of the characters; aren't touching the ground. They feel like they're hovering around.
You know that. Everything's clunky.
It's repetitive. The loot isn't satisfying. Nothing is actually satisfying. I swear to God, these gloves that I got, they look like oven mitts. Cold resistance, stamina cost reduction. Oh, I got a ring with a horn on it. It's a horny ring.
Oh, look, I look like Sylvanas now, I swear to God.
Yeah! This gives me one extra dexterity, one less extra armor. Tempest champion helm. Oh, this is actually better. I want to see the horn helmet. Look at that. Look how stupid the helmet looks. Why is it? Is it purple? It looks like it's glass purple and it has like a storm's inside the helmet, but it kind of matches the hammer. Look at the oven mitts. Oh my God, I swear to God, they look like winter gloves, you know, the fingerless winter gloves. Now the character models aren't that detailed. Okay, this helmet is slightly better. And here is where you can assign feats.
Yeah, so...
Can I... unlock physical damage bonus. Can I unlock some new moves? Yeah, I think we can. We have the money.
I can unlock... Tap forward and right button for some shit, and then while walking backward.
And this is the essence of the game. You get some loot that looks, you look blind, bro. That looks sort of meh. You fight some enemies that are meh, by the way, in case you didn't notice, the final boss was like a slight reskin of the trolls we've been fighting throughout the level, so no real creativity there. You can try playing different characters, but you have to level them up individually. It's gonna be a grind. I guess this game would merit at most just to finish like every mission from the campaign, just to see every boss, maybe get a little bit of story, but besides that, it's got no meat on its bones. It's not gonna be one of those time killer games. It's definitely not worth the 30 plus pounds that it costs on the Xbox store right now. I mean, it's okay as a, let's say, a free game with the Game Pass subscription, but even so, there are way better games out there. I would rather play Anthem than this. It's more enjoyable. I would play Vermintide rather than this. I would play Outriders, and Outriders I quite enjoyed, even though the story was horrible.
But I laughed a lot at that.
Yeah, at least it was fun. You can't make your own fun. It's nothing fun about the game. It's actually frustrating. And the only thing that could be fun is that if you run into a glitch or a bug, or you see a boss flying through the wall after you hit it once or something like that. But that's just a moment of fun, you know? It's not a playstyle. It's not a good game, guys. I'm sorry, this is not a good game, and I'm not gonna continue playing this. We got other way better games to finish, and Some we haven't even touched yet. So this has been Dungeons & Dragons Dark Alliance on the Xbox Series S. I'm sorry, but the game is not playable at this moment. I don't recommend buying this game whatsoever. It still needs a lot of fixes, a lot of patches maybe. And even then, I don't think it's a good contender to what's already on the market. So, yeah. Bro, any conclusions for this game? Because
no.
I doubt you're going to want to continue playing this game, right?
Oh, no. It's not worth the time, effort, or anything, because it's so unfinished and it needs a lot of work. And even after the work, I don't guarantee it's gonna be in even close to a good game. So, I'm sorry about the game, but nah, it's not worth the effort, time, or money for it.
Yeah, my thoughts exactly. Well, guys, this is gonna be the video. Drop a like if you enjoyed it. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.